note that I'd like to end with tonight, I want to invite this great band to come back up here because they're going to have something to do here in a moment. I want to end with one of my favorite explicit pieces of gospel proclamation, I think. And this is one of my favorite musicians of all time, everybody's favorite musician of all time, I guess. Louis Armstrong, whose statue stands down there in New Orleans, one of the founders and shapers of the jazz tradition in American life that I so happily try to participate in myself, playing this. Whole way from Boston. This is a borrowed saxophone, by the way. But it's a very good one. I'm thinking of taking it back with me, even if I didn't bring it along. And so we're going to listen to Louis playing one of the most familiar of all the things he ever played. And I want you to stand up while you hear this, please. Everybody stand up. This is When the Saints Go Marching In. And if you feel like marching, please do. And we're going to hear Louis play it and sing it, and then you're going to hear this band and this saxophone, play it. Okay.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, here's one you all can sing with us. When the Saints Go Marching In.
Saints. Let's sing, everybody.
Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, Lord, I want to be in that number. Oh, when the saints go marching in.
It's still Louis' band playing. You're going to hear this one in a minute. Louis Armstrong is a warm-up group. That's quite unusual. We fade that out. Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Now we're going to hear the band unaccompanied by me. It'll sound even better, I'm sure.
Okay, well, hello, testing, check, okay. So we're going to play something now, too. Awesome, okay. The night is full of surprises. Y'all, have y'all been surprised a couple of times? Are we playing with you, or do you want us just to do one of our worship songs? Okay, awesome. Clap with me. God is able. He will never fail. He is almighty. Greater than all we ask, He has done great things. Lifted up, He defeated the grave. Raised to life, our God is able. In His name, we He will go before.
questions. We have just a few minutes for questions. If anybody has one, just stand up where you are, say it good and loud. It's fair game. Don't you act like Methodist. Very quiet. No questions tonight? You must have wowed them. Yes, please stand. Okay.
Hey, that's a great question. Why didn't I pick anything that's just strictly instrumental music? I think it was a cowardly retreat for me to find some songs that have had some words in it that evoked what Jesus had actually taught. And therefore, I didn't select any strictly instrumental music, but I like strictly instrumental music, whether it's classical or jazz. So next time I do this, I will make sure to include a couple of those things. So please invite me to come back down here to Huntsville, and I will include some things like that for you. Thanks for the question. Good reminder. Any other questions?
Yes, stand.
Maybe I'll read a more recent one. Yes, the question is perfectly fine. The answer is going to be a little hard to formulate, I think. The question was, there are people in the world who are willing to give up their lives. I think you mentioned some people in the Muslim faith or things that they believe in, but we don't hear much of a challenge, I think, in our churches to be willing to give up our lives for what we believe in, and that's probably true. Of course, we are Christians in the name of one who did give up his life for us, for what he believed in. That's our principal example, and there have been many people along the line over the centuries, and even in our own time, who have done that. So, but it's not something that most of us are called upon to do. I'm thinking of, for example, the famous Dietrich Bonhoeffer, the German pastor and martyr who was killed by the Nazis, or Bishop Oscar Romero, the Roman Catholic bishop in El Salvador, who was killed by a death squad for standing on the side of the people who were being persecuted. They're the four wonderful church women in El Salvador who were raped and killed. We are still sometimes called upon to do that, but the pastor mentioned that one of the most valuable experiences I've had in my whole